Man, there's no reason for me to open this. What you got in these lockers? Ooh! Pulse grenades. The good stuff in here. Okay, an M60. And I'm full.
What do you want?
It's what you want. That you don't know what you want yet. Here, have this. Have that. I gave him a motor and a small piece of machinery. And a drill. Navcom parts. I'll keep the rest of this then. Okay, good. You best to be sorry. Oh, this is the one that has the gun. I wish there was a way to explore this without having to close it and then reopen it. There you go, M60. Empty. Combat knife and a club. Ooh. Rocket launcher. More stuff for Marcus. Ooh, explosive rocket. Can't even carry it. Okay. Is there another locker past this that we can't see? No. What is this? A treadmill. Marcus.
What do you want?
Came along just in time. Have this crap. Thank you. Can I carry these comfortably? Yeah, I guess, for now. I don't want to give them to Marcus. I don't want him to use them. Not sure if he's trained in that kind of stuff, but I don't want him blowing off rockets unexpectedly near us. Doesn't appeal to me. Oh, geez. Gonna lock us inside? I want to open all doors. Air processing unit. An APU cleans the old air to provide new air for the complex. Can I even get to that thing? Or only to the computer that controls it, possibly. Oh god. Keep forgetting. Just know I have the card and just let me in. Somehow he... What? At least it remembers now. Okay. Cool. Two more stim packs. This computer. Can we do anything with that? Apparently not. Okay. The remains of a sentry bot mark II. This is 4. I must have just skipped 5. Huh. Crazy me. Thing is, I have to unlock it with this and then open it. It's like, just be friendly. You be user friendly and open for me. Oof! Lot of ammo. Nice. Five super stim packs. Sweet. I love this room. Oh, okay, so 20 flamethrower fuel. Do I have another one sometimes? Okay. Sometimes they have stuff over where the wall is hiding. Okay, an assault rifle and a bunch of more ammo. Not surprising. How close am I? Can I just take the gun? Because I want to unload as much as I can, too. No. Okay, I'm going to give this all to Marcus.
What do you want?
I want to give you things. Things to make you sing. Needler cartridges. It is pretty, like, rare ammo, too. Don't want to give him that. Oh, I still got the gun. What is this? Electronic lockpick mark II? And some more biomed gel. I want to make sure I get this weapon. This is a second generation Watts electronics micromanipulator finger stuff. Electronic lockpick for defeating electronic locks and security devices. This Mark II version includes updated software and interface tools. £2. That's nice. So, I'll try to use that for my electronic locked stuff. Eh.
What do you want?
It's what I don't want. Some more biomed gel. I've got the Mark II, so you know what? Take the regular one. Yeah. Like caught in mid-yawn.
What do you want?
Have this stuff too. So this stuff looks pretty interesting. Oh. A reinforced door for the security wing. I looked at it by mistake. Yeah. I'm on 140. Hold on a second. I'm on 144 actually. Oops. Yeah, when I do that, the music gets messed up. Nothing out of the ordinary. A situation map. Okay, nothing to do in here then? Oh, I keep forgetting this. Wait. I was aimed at myself. It does nothing? We can just open this? Conform code. Okay, abre. Unlocking door, thank you. Museum picture. Okay, this is a museum. Victory! A desk! Okay, EPA pamphlet. Cheesy Poofs, Nuka-Cola. We can make one of those things now, that with the fruit and the Nuka-Cola. Wait, what was I trying to make? And guns and bullets. The pamphlet I've seen before, pretty sure. It's stacked, so it's three, it's the same thing. Yeah, same stuff we've seen before. World map. Let me guess, we access the computers and they play out stuff for us. EPA's museum computer. Can't get to that one, he's in the way. So I'll just run to this one. Oh goody. Welcome to the EPA's museum. This terminal will project a movie using exciting new holographic technology. The movie is an entertaining and informational look at the scary, but possible, reality of a post-nuclear world. Play movie. The terminal projects a hologram of a tall, bespectacled man in a lab coat. He waves and gives you a friendly smile. Hello, I'm Dr. Caleb, and I'll be hosting this holographic video on a post-Holocaust America. I was hoping it was going to play like a cutscene or something. A living room materializes around Dr. Caleb, where a family appears to be relaxing for the evening. Dr. Caleb pats the head of the family dog, then smiles at you. Meet the Johnsons. They're your average American family. Dad smokes his pipe, Mom reads her cookbook, and little Billy and Susie catch some boob tube before bedtime. They think everything will be just fine. They ignore the warning sirens, thinking that it's just another drill. Oh, but what's this? Through the back window, you see a large bomb crash to the earth, creating a massive mushroom cloud explosion, followed by a blinding light. Once the light fades away, you see Dr. Caleb is now standing in the burnt ruins of the living room, with the family replaced by skeletons. Uh-oh, it looks like the commies dropped the big one, and the Johnsons weren't quite as safe as they thought. Now, where can we learn from the Johnson family's mistake? First we can take a drink, then we'll learn from their mistake. That's right. In the event of a nuclear war, you want your family to be safe within the shelter of a Vault-Tec brand vault. Vault-Tec have constructed 122 public vaults around our great nation, so there's bound to be one near you. That's so many, huh? 122? As you can imagine, space is very limited, so reserve your space today, or else your family might end up like the Johnsons here. Dr. Caleb pats the head of the skeletal dog. The skull detaches from the body and hits the floor, shattering. A Mr. Handy robot hovers over and sweeps up the skull fragments. So is that who created the vaults then? It was the EPA? Or the EPA created Vault-Tec? Who in turn created the vaults? It looks like Mr. Handy's going to have his work cut out for him if he plans to clean up this mess. Dr. Caleb laughs as the image fades away and is replaced by text. Thank you for watching. This educational video was brought to you by the fine folks at Vault-Tec. Vault-Tec, America's final word in homes. Okay. And what about this one? Can you move so I can access this computer? You take it easy. Okay, so there's another informational look at the scary but possible reality of a post-nuclear world. Same text. Oh, it's the same thing? Oh, damn. Oh. How disappointing. I thought it would be a different movie. Alright. That's the museum. Oh, duh. We're not. Oh, we can just get in, okay. The door is very noisy and you guys have to go through it individually. I wonder if we're gonna have some reason to electrify somebody. Because we have an option to turn a chair on and off. Like, why? Why do we have that option? Okay, we've explored this whole area. Marcus is overloaded. I was not aware of this.
What do you want?
I want you to be not overloaded. Oh, yeah. How are you now? Better. Guess I can give that stuff to Sulik. What you be needin'?
What you be needin'?
Should have checked him first, but now I'm here. Yeah. How are you doing? Oh, you can take a lot more. You're gonna hold these rockets then. Give one person the gun and give the other person the ammo so they don't have. Oh, you know what? Just check this. I should probably make sure it's not loaded with something.
What do you want?
Not so fast there, buddy. It has a rocket in there. Give me that. No huge explosions to kill us.
What you be need?
Yeah, take this. How much is that? I can't see the weight from here. Never mind. Okay. Safely disarmed the rocket launcher. Alright, let's leave. I'm thinking he's now no longer overloaded. Too bad we can't get anything useful off these robots. So hang down to level 6 then. Oh. Problem with the elevator? Do I have to use this? Probably not. It's probably just broken, but... Alright, never mind. I'll have to repair his thing. His, Now it's telling me it's not working, now that I've walked all the way over here. Okay, we have to fix this. Hold on, guys. Just want to look at this. Fixed a hologram that speaks with static. Try using the tool. Does nothing. Cannot repair that. Maybe I need to fix this generator, not the computer. I cannot get there. I can too get there, I'm right there. Alright, let's try to repair the skill. Is Vic trying to do it? Is Vic even with us? I'll try. Goris, you're gonna have to move. I'm not sure what's going on. Let's have Goris stay here. Wait here. Still saying I can't get there. Unless it means this. Let's go down here then. Incorrect password. Does nothing. I guess I'm trying Aubrey. Doesn't say I am. But it's telling me incorrect password. And this doesn't work. Okay. Okay, I don't know what to do with this. Figured that would repair him, but... Let's go down to 6. Want eats? Ugh. You know what though? I left Goris up top. forgot to tell him to come with us. He's gotta scrutinize us every time. Come on. Let me through. What happened there? Stuff skipping. Please let me through. Oh god, come on. One hell of a wedgie. Oh, and did it open? Or I just still gotta... Okay, so now we can let these things out of their misery. Horribly disfigured humans. Does this let the force fields down? Information or employee access. Welcome to the EPA Petting Zoo. Here you'll have the pleasure of interacting with these unique creatures that look like hideous deformed humans. That's because these ugly beasts are the result of exciting experiments where our brilliant scientists are attempting to splice human and animal DNA. In theory, this new science might one day allow us to create a super person. Imagine a US soldier with the sight of an eagle, the speed of a cheetah, and the strength of an ape. Imagine how this super soldier would strike fear into the hearts of commies. Commies, really, it sounds like science fiction, but it may soon be science fact. The creatures you see here are the results of experiments that haven't quite met with success. Instead of euthanizing these failed abominations, we thought it'd be fun to put them in a petting zoo. Don't worry, despite their horrific appearance, they're not likely to attack as long as they're well fed. We're happy to report only 3 visitor casualties have occurred in the past year. No casualties are good. 3 is not good. Especially 3 is not good when hardly anybody visits this place. Okay, so I guess employee access will let down the fields. Lower force field. To lower force fields, please enter access password. If password is lost or forgotten, please see hologram 40011, Director of Public Relations. Abre. Thank you. Force fields are now disengaged. You know what, though? I don't need the bug spray right now, do I? Got 19 of these super stim packs. Freaking awesome. I didn't reach any of them here, so... Run away! Too late for you! I don't have anything to feed them, so might as well kill them. Experience and all that. You like this? One dead. I'm not gonna be hungry much longer. 2 dead. Oh yeah, this is where it's at. And 3. Snarl. That's it. We gained 5 karma and 460 XP. I don't suppose these guys have anything on them. Probably not. Dead ravenous human. Poor things. Scattered remains. Are these human? With a exclamation mark, not a question mark. Yeah, empty. Alright. Hello, computer. Here you can see plant life unlike any you've seen before. This exciting new species, derived from the Venus flytrap, was specifically engineered by our brilliant scientists to be able to survive in a world devastated by a nuclear war. Why would we want to do that? It's simple. After a global nuclear war, scientists believe that much of the Earth will become a barren wasteland. Plant life will have a difficult time surviving in this harsh new environment. Now imagine us emerging from the safety of our Vault-Tec vaults only to find that all the plants are dead. That'd mean no more salads for Mom, and no more lawns for Billy and Rover to play fetch in. So excuse me, you're gonna make a salad out of these things? Or have them play fetch among these things? Billy and Rover will be very dead. Sounds terrible, doesn't it? Yes. But don't worry, these new plants may be the answer to that problem. Instead of relying on fertile soil and rainfall, they're able to derive nutrients by killing and eating animals just like people. All through the wonders of science. How do they even get nutrients from people if they shoot spikes on them and they die feet away? Another failed experiment. Lower force field. Disengaged.